Morning.
I'm here with Rolando Arellano, the manager of Victor Ortiz, and I caught up with him talking about Victor Ortiz, Josecito Lopez, Victor Ortiz, Canelo Alvarez, and the judging, the fiasco, what went down, Manny Pacquiao, Tim Bradley. Check it out.
That's right. That's how it works here at Team Ortiz.
Rolando, Victor has a very big fight June 23 against Josecito Lopez.
Yes, sir.
Now all the pressure's off Lopez.
Yes.
Because he's already saying, hey, they're talking about Victor Canelo. How are you guys taking this? We have two fights lined up.
No, see, people got it a little bit confused, right? There is no Canelo fight, right? Because it's a contingency on us winning, right? So basically my job as a manager, right, is to exploit the best opportunities for my fighters, even if it means that I have to plan ahead of time. Victor has one job and one job only, and that's to basically beat Josecito Lopez, right? If I see an opportunity that's in the best benefit for this team, I will start putting that into place. And that's exactly what happened here. We got an opportunity, I grabbed it, and it's based on us winning. Okay, but that opportunity cannot be exploited unless we win here. So versus, most people say, man, is that a lot of pressure? No, we turn it around, we make it something positive. We create an incentive, right? An incentive which creates a little bit more motivation, gives a little bit more inspiration to get to the next level. And I graduate high school before you go to college.
Or
you got to put the college out there.
Or sometimes when you have a fight and if you win, you become the mandatory. It's kind of like that.
Yeah.
You know the next fight that's coming up against a champ.
Absolutely. You know what? Because, once again, it creates an incentive for him to do, real, real good. You know? But once it's on a contingency plan. You know? And so we redirect Victor's focus to the fight at hand. And the management has an obligation to do what I did. How foolish if I would have said, hey, Arellano, the opportunity's here and we need an answer in the next couple of days. And I go, no, you know what? I'm not going to do that. I'm not doing that.
Who's going
to
turn down such a fight?
That's right. Basically, you put everything in motion, you know? And my team is ready and willing to go June the 23rd.
Right before they announced Victor Canelo, the entire world was tired of boxing, sick of boxing. Just because what happened this weekend between Pacquiao and Bradley was such a turnoff. And this brought the hope back. This brought fans back.
Absolutely, because look, this is bigger than Victor and Canelo. Basically, this is for the WBC championship. This is for the knockout king. This is to determine who is going to be the next great pay-per-view fighter out there. You know what I mean? So the implications here are a lot greater than most people think. It's just another fight. No, and you have two young fighters that are pretty much, you know what, at their game right now. You know, and the question is, which one's going to be the greater one? You know, and it's a great style. Canelo is young, he's strong, he wants to fight, and Victor is young and strong and has power for both hands, right? And this fight is going to end in a knockout, you know, and it's going to be Canelo's going to get knocked out, not us. You know what, we believe that our style will basically be used to neutralize his style. You know?
Speaking of which, what did all you three, or what did you guys think about the Pacquiao Bradley fight? Did you see it?
Yeah, I did. Look, in my opinion, I had Pacquiao winning 10 out of 12 rounds. You know what? I think that it's a shame that the Nevada Athletic Commission says that he will not critically review what happened in the judging. Couple of things it's necessary. When something happens, you always reassess it. Why do you reassess it? To see if you can learn and make it better. Okay? So let's see if there was the appearance of impropriety. Let's determine if there was any actual impropriety. And if there wasn't, let's check to see what are the training protocols for the judges. How do we determine their standard of competence?
Their knowledge.
You have judges that are 70 plus years old. How do we know whether they still have the cognizant capability? Nothing personal, the cognizant capability of watching a real action fight, you know, and making the right call on the fight. You know what? They limit military personnel at a certain age. They limit pilots at a certain age. So these things should be reviewed for the empowerment and the embetterment of the sport. Not to be something negative, not to point the finger at something else, but when you have continual controversy and a clear pattern of these controversies, let's review them. Let's understand why they're happening and let's change it so that they don't occur again, because it was terrible.
And it's not only terrible for Manny, or terrible for fights, for his fans, but it's terrible for the whole sport of boxing, because I'm having so many people who are not hardcore fans who just tune in for the big ones saying, we'll never watch again. They don't know the difference of one promoter to another. They don't know the difference. They just know they tune in, watch a fight, and they feel robbed.
Yeah, absolutely. Because not only are they tuning in, they are customers. They're consumers. They're paying $59, $69 for these fights. You know what? And they want to. They really want to, and they want to hope that there's a sense of legitimacy, right? And when you get a tainted cloud that comes over our sports again, you know what? Here we go. Now we have to fight to clean ourselves again. And we're doing it with Canelo and Ortiz.
That's going to be a knockout. Don't bring your scorecards.
That's
leave
right.
them at home.
Yeah, yeah. Leave the judges at home, too. And
there you have it. Rolando Arellano. Stay tuned for more right here in Ventura from the training camp of Victor Ortiz for ESPN Report.com. I'm Isaac Pack reporting.